Hey, hey, friends. We have Monroe and Shylo Bijou here, and it is the classroom. Let's get started.
Hey, everybody. So we just got off a super hot coaching call with some of my clients, and we talked about a topic that is honestly like the freest free game on the planet that people just aren't taking advantage of, that happens to be of the female gender. Okay. And I don't understand why, because the Bible literally talks about this. The lowest of the low, the first will become last and last become first. It's prophecy. Okay. So we're a little biblical around here, but because we're custom Christians, hey, love us anyways. And one of the things I want you guys to understand is that there are incentives, reparations, things that have been created for women and women of color, especially, to facilitate funding and access that other people cannot get. There, that means that just like how certain workplaces have to fill a quota of having people with disability, of having women and women of color, men of color in their businesses, there are minority accreditation that you can acquire for your business entity. You cannot be a business partner to the government if you are a civilian, a citizen. That, we're not going to talk about that today. That's taking a little deep when it comes to being a citizen. But let me just tell you, you need to be a corporation. And don't just go sign up for any old corporation right now. There's different perks. We can go into a specific thing. I have a few guests that are specialists in this area that we can bring on to talk about the difference between an LLC, an S-Corp, and a C-Corp, and which one works best for you and your family. But this is something I want you to think about, because you may be a service provider. You may be a business coach. You may be a funding specialist. You may be a graphic designer. You may be a contractor or manage contractors, and there are government contracts, which is recession-proof income that you can get alignment, especially with COVID times. We don't know what we're looking at from a financial standpoint with this government, but what we do know is that government contracts will pay out no matter what, because why? The government that runs everything has to hold up their deal. There are so many laws in place to help facilitate distribution of funding and access and resources to people who have minority accreditation. One of my biggest pet peeves, because I mentor business owners and startup, and I mentor women exiting corporate America that don't want to drop below a six-figure salary. They want to just transition clearly across into entrepreneurship. And one of my biggest pet peeves is the first move that they want to make is buying, you know, $5,000, $10,000, $25,000 in inventory when they haven't done market research, they haven't gotten a corporate structure, they haven't gotten a business coach. And a lot of that is because they think limited resource. We were just talking about making your money work for you. We were just talking about leveraging business credit to facilitate entering into your dream life, right? And so many people, especially women, we're used to the hustle, we're used to the grind, we're used to getting up from the mud or bootstrapping everything. And that's not the season that we're in, sis. I'm sorry, but I don't want wrinkles. I don't need both. I look young as hell. I'm 27. Okay. I'm going to continue to age backwards. And it's because I don't be stressing myself out. I be relaxing. Why? Because I got little soldiers that are working for me. And those little soldiers are my US dollars. Y'all have heard me on any other platform. You know, I don't be talking about how I like US dollars. The only thing that it is good for is working for me. Okay. I don't need 100,000 employees when I got $100,000. And if you learn how to facilitate leveraging business credit, which allows you to get access to huge amounts of funding, right? And when you start your business, instead of going and spend that $5,000, $10,000, $25,000 on inventory and trying to figure out how to make it work, you actually go get yourself a business entity for $300 to $500. You establish that, you get yourself a business bank account, put that little money, let it sit there for 30 days and watch yourself access up to $150,000 in business credit without over leveraging yourself. And then from there, you can afford to pay for a marketing specialist. You can afford to do your market research. You can afford your inventory. You can afford a business coach. You can afford your storefront. You can pay your lease up for a year. And now you're making boss moves. This is why these men always have a head start, because their daddy taught them how the game works. No one's teaching us how the game works. We were taught how to cook. Some of us weren't lucky enough to even learn that. I know that was me. I still be struggling in the kitchen, but I'd be doing my best. But it's a game changer when you learn that your business entity can operate as an additional you. I don't know if there's anything that you wanted to hop in on that, but this is like a topic that I feel like, especially high level women, if you learn how to leverage your corporate entity and you learn how to leverage your corporate sale to protect yourself, protect your assets and your family, but also create huge leverage, it's a different game, because we're what makes the world go around. Let's be real about that. So go ahead, Shylo.
This is what I'm going to bring in. We had lots of conversations last night outside of these rooms. And, you know, here's what I'm going to say. I'm going to break this down, because when Meaghan comes in, she comes in hot. Like, y'all just got schooled. I mean, we could be done with the show. Like, everyone could be like, I need to go back, rewind, and then take it and break it down. So we're going to break it down a little bit for everybody, because I'll be like, last night I was telling you, I never let my husband, or I let my husband do everything. That was one of my things, because I was in a retreat mode. Like, I was going through legal battles, and I was stressing. So what my mode was, let him take care of the finances, and I ignored major things. I was building a massive empire over here, but I was so distraught that I was like, oh, you take care of that, and you take care of that. So as I'm going through this separation, and I'm building out, so I get separated, divorced, and I have all these things happening right now. And as we're coming into this season, Meaghan, you know what's happening. I mean, we're taking out, we've got so much going on. I was like, I don't know what any of this is. And I'm speaking for a lot of the listeners right now, because you know there's women hopping on here going, I don't understand what she just said.
What did she just say?
Okay, what did she just say? Don't worry, that's me. That's me. So I want to relate to everybody, because Meaghan is just this, she's at a next level, and this is what she teaches. This is what she does. So just know that we don't expect you to understand everything that she just said. What I'm saying is, we have to stop hiding. Like, there's times where I wouldn't even open my bank account. I'm like, I don't want to look at it. There was nothing wrong. I didn't want to look at it. I was so scared. I did not have a business banking. What? I was running millions a year. I didn't have business banking. I didn't know what an S corp was. I'm like, I have an LLC. I got an LLC maybe 4 years ago, but there was things that happening. We were talking just now. Like, if I would have known what I know now and what I'm learning, because I don't know it completely. When I went through a really large lawsuit, it would have been such a different story if I would have had myself set up different. I could have protected myself. I was not protected, y'all. I went through, God, Meaghan, one of the worst battles, and you were with me on that journey for a lot of it. Like, you saw some stuff, and you didn't even see some of the stuff. Like, it was such a private journey, but also I let a little stuff here and there, but it had to be private. And it's like, for anyone that's building, you need to accept that you don't understand this stuff. You could be a top recruiter, you could be a salesperson, you could be Fortune 500 company. If you do not know what this stuff means, it doesn't matter how much money you make, it's gonna go out as fast as it came in, and somebody can take it from you like that. I'm just saying, like, it's really important to have that part of the story too, Meaghan, because there are a lot of women who, like, that would have broke, and it broke me. Let's be real. It broke me, but it would have destroyed someone in their business forever. There are a lot of people who don't come back from that. In my industry, you understand this, the industry that you're in as well. People leave. And we see people walk away from, and they're talented. Here's the deal. I am so good at what I'm good at, but I'm really bad at what I'm not. Like, that's the finances, but that doesn't mean you always have to be that way. And I was just putting it off, like, oh, I'm going to put that over here, or I'm going to let someone else deal with that. And I still tend to do that sometimes, but I have to pay attention and I have to learn it. So what I'm admitting, and what for a lot of women on the show and men too, you have to learn this, but it's okay not to know it.
Yeah.
Just know that there's so many options. Please never think you're going to drown, because you're not. So reach out and let's break it down for our listeners and our viewers, because they're ready to hear what this is about. So let's talk. We can just use me as an example. Okay, I have an S corp. So what would you recommend for people who, you know, they have a business? A lot of people have LLCs. They don't even understand what they can do with it. So let's talk about the benefits of an LLC, or if they don't have one, why they should have one.
So for me with LLCs, I never recommend them. And it's because I recommend asset protection. And the best way to do that is with a trust. And so it goes, trusts are so easy to set up, but you need to have a corporation. And an LLC does not get all the, it goes from like 147 tax breaks with an LLC to like 300 and something with a corporation. And so an S corp is a good option for you, but you should also be running and buying. If you buy houses, if you buy rental properties, if you own cars, you can finance your cars with no personal guarantee, meaning that your name and your credit report is not on that thing. And some of you guys may be coming out of messy situations. You may be going from a divorce. You may have had a situation where you had to come back and you ruined your credit because you were young. I know that's something that I personally did. I had no clue about credit, and I only had a few things on there, but I was 20. No one taught me about financial literacy. And so the power of a business entity is that you can establish business credit that you can use to finance everyday things. You can even do corporate leasing for apartments. I know we're big into Airbnbs right now. And part of the things is we can go get 10 corporate leases for Airbnb with our business account and our EIN. And we just get those leases signed. That's no deposit down because it's a corporate lease. Okay. Then you go and you get business credit at some of these furniture places. You finance the furniture. And by the end of the month, that unit is completely paid for by the rental people. And you can literally get on there and target. So there's so many plays that people who get in a position of leverage by just incorporating it with a corporation, structuring yourself to where you are completely an employee for your business. That's a huge thing that we were discussing on the class too, is like, you guys need to hire yourselves. And what happens when you have an employment contract with your own business is you're not flaunting around for 10 hours in the morning getting, and I'm talking about myself right now. I always be talking about myself. So if I'm saying something, just know I'm telling you my business. Okay, y'all. Cause I will wake up in the morning. I'm driving my butt to Starbucks with my hair every freaking where. I'm sitting in the thing, I'm laughing at the person listening to my gangster beats, okay? Or sometimes if the Holy Spirit hit me, I may be listening to some worship music or a mixture of both. Sometimes I'll be doing that, okay? And then I'll spend 3 hours doing whatever until I have appointments at noon or whatever. I want you guys to understand that if you have a corporate agreement with yourself, and I call this our self-wealth blueprint, and it's a four-step process that I teach my students, but it's where you facilitate what your employee contract looks like. And even in that process, Shylo has a lot of these tools in our Comeback Queen coaching program. But in that process, I have things that help me with systematic ascension for my depression. So I'm hired by my corporation to feel good every day. If I am spiraling down because I deal with depression, if I'm spiraling, that means that I have to legally under contract go get my butt in the bathroom, some Epsom salt, some lavender, some candles, and go through my self-ascension process. And it's allocated in my employee contract to take those 2 hours. Okay, you guys need to be thinking about, how do I facilitate protecting myself? How do I stop commingling funds, which is the biggest thing that women do in their businesses? They're not structured properly, they're not financed properly, and they're putting their business expenses in personal accounts and vice versa. And then you get yourself in an agreement with your business where your car is paid for, your lights are paid for, your phone's paid for, your house is paid for in your employee contract, and you have a salary on top of that. That's all in your contract. And what's even better is you can negotiate your contract with your own entity. So you can say, well, entity, I actually need a $2,000 traveling budget. And then you sign yourself over a $2,000 traveling budget. That's all tax deductible. So yes, we get write-offs as sole proprietors. We do get write-offs as LLCs, but those become even bigger and broader. You can write off your whole G-Wagon. We can write off our Lamborghinis up to 75%. You guys, these rich people, these influencers on social media, they don't pay for those cars out of pocket. Those cars are financed by credit with a business corporation and write off at the end of the year, so they're not having to pay taxes on that. It's how they save money through the tax play. So this is the game. Do you want to play this game? That's the question. I know it seems complicated, but it's as simple as 5 contracts and a filing fee. That's it. You know what I'm saying? So,
well, I think this is the season to play. Okay. So the word has come up a lot. You say it a lot. I work with a shaman, Ruth, who says playing all the time. That's part of our vocabulary. And I've been starting to say it. I think it's just the season. Like when we're called to do some of this play. And so one of the other things that is really exciting is that you have to go all in, right? And you messaged me earlier and you're like, oh my God, you were asking me something. And I'm like, you're giving me anxiety. But at the same time, my anxiety comes from, it's a good anxiety. Cause I'm like, that means I have to go all in. And yep. It also means I need to educate myself. So what happens is, it's like, okay, what areas do I have to tighten up? This is really smart for a lot of people that I know, a lot of entrepreneurs, they're so talented. It's the talent, right? They've got the freaking talent and they just got the personalities, right? They can just do it and they have relationship skills and that gets them only so far. That's a me. But then your systems and structures too. So you have that other quality in there where I have to get better. I have to tighten up the ship. And see, I'm owning this too. See, I talk about myself all the time too, because I want people to understand, I don't say things out of the air. I say them from experience and I own a lot of my shit. Like where I'm like, oh yeah, I'm not good at that. And I'm like, maybe I should have done that better. And I do know that. And so for me, this time that we're coming into is all out massive action. And I know there are people watching and listening going, I'm getting anxious. I don't know what she meant, I'm scared I'm not doing things right. Here's the deal. There's ways. We've got you. We've got you. So know that no matter what, if you hear something on this show, you're like, I need to know what this is. Just tap into Monroe.
Yeah.
Tap into her. Like if she's something, yeah. Go.
Just go to the group. Go to the group. We have all this information. You guys right now, if you are a sole proprietor right now that is struggling with paying your rent, you could go in my Facebook group for free, go to the announcement post and get up to $45,000 in funding just because you're a sole proprietor, woman-based business. Okay. Like I put people on game. Why? Because it's expensive to hire me. So I need you to be financed. So I give people the free game. To get them, we call it solvent. People want to be sovereign all day long. They want no tax liability. They want to get, you know, by having to be able to fly on private jets. They want to go across the country and network and do all these big parties. They want to own the things. They want the mansions. They want the stuff. But you can't be sovereign if you're not solvent. Financial literacy, being solvent, is your next step, sis. Because when you can clean up your foundation, you can build your empire. You don't need anybody's permission. You just need the knowledge and the power of what the way that women are working right now. I mean, I have this information, but guess what? I have experts that I'm going to connect you to that are going to teach you these processes step by step so you understand what you're in, right? People are in the community delivering that type of quality information. Because here's the deal, we're better together. These men work together in groups of 5, 10, sometimes 20 of them come together, fund a project. They own apartment buildings with 80 different units, 150 units, and they're doing that with their backdoor business credit. You take a bunch of entities and you turn yourself into a bank, okay? You can turn your family into a bank. I learned that play and I was so mad at myself because get this, your dollars need to work 4 times for you before they leave your family. They need to work for you 4 times. Your $1 needs to have the equivalent of $4 spending power in your family. You need to know how to layer yourself properly. Don't get overwhelmed by this stuff, okay? I'm just putting you on game. I'm giving you something to turn your compass on because now watch, this information is in you and you're aware of it now. So now you're gonna start hearing conversations. You're gonna catch information you didn't understand before. And moving forward, as we begin to unveil these and we bring our guests on and we show you people who can give you step-by-step instructions in these space, action-oriented, get it done steps, you're going to be so excited that you learn new terms, okay? I know corporate veil and employee agreements and all these things is like, what the heck? But I promise you, it's going to be fun having that extra 40% of your income every year to go spend on family vacation or what have you. You want to work smarter, not harder. I didn't understand what that meant when I was sitting here like, how am I supposed to do this? I'm breastfeeding a baby. I've got 2 laptops open. I'm burning the midnight hours. Guess what? We're done with the hustle, you guys. Like I said, we're aging backwards. Stop overworking yourself. Stop over-leveraging yourself when you can over-leverage what it means to be a business partner of the United States. And I know that they're a little messy sometimes, but I promise you that's where you want to be if you're doing business on this land, because they have facilitated certain things that they just don't educate us about, because then their IRS partner isn't making as much money. And that's not saying that you're doing anything wrong. You're doing it right. They honor you with resources, with funding, with partnerships, and with contracts when you play their game properly. Know that. Okay. Know that.
Mm-hmm. So I want to tell a little story. So, you know, when people are on here and they're watching us, I want everyone to know I come from a town of like 3,000 people. No one taught me this because they didn't know it. So I want people to give themselves grace on this because I'm learning this now. I'm 40. You have an opportunity, no matter where you are, to learn this. And honestly, once you grab here's the thing. Even if I can't learn all the things, I know who to look to. I have people where I can go, I can ask them that. They can help me with this. It's all about your connections. So don't stress about that stuff. Like I think about my parents. My dad worked on the railroad. My mom was on disability when she was in her 30s. So she'd worked in hotels. She worked a server. She was a bartender. She had a business of her own in her younger years. And she, you know, she was hustling all the time. She got hurt and she could only do what she could do with a disability. And so my parents never were taught this stuff. This wasn't encouraged. My dad knew that he would have a railroad retirement when he died. That's the financial advice he got. Make sure you have a retirement and good credit. well, we can't think like that anymore. Like, he taught me how to have good credit, and I'm grateful because that was instilled in me. So many people don't understand this, and I want everyone to understand, Monroe doesn't come from this background.
The streets, bro.
Yeah, let's talk about your background really quick. Like, real quick, in a nutshell, like, tell people, where do you come from? Like, just anybody can learn this, so if you can learn this, if I can learn this, anybody can learn this.
My childhood was so traumatic that by the time I was 16, I didn't even want to go to a party. I had seen people get their kids. I had seen people shoot up drugs. I grew up with a family that was in church, and then they got hurt by the church, fell off. We were poor. My parents became hoarders, and they were dealing with severe depression from 11 till 15. I ended up leaving my home at 16 and was in foster care. I ran the streets to run income so that I could afford to eat. And it was like, you know, I wasn't like other kids. I would host parties and charge a cover like thing like that because I was a good networker. Like, I was smart. I had a locker store. All these things, you know, I was smart about it, and I've always had the finesse. But when I turned 19 and I started to pay myself through college, and I was working 16-hour shifts Monday through Friday, I would go to work at 4 and wake up at 7, go to school at 8 and go to school till 3:30, drive to my job, do my homework, sleep at my job. That was my life. I was making $14 an hour under the table, but I got pregnant. Mm-hmm. And at that point, I was partying on the weekends, living my best life. I had more Miss Me jeans. I bought new pairs every weekend than you guys could imagine. If you guys know what those are, they're anywhere from $100 to $200 jeans, and I had a bunch of them. Okay, I just bought clothes every weekend. I didn't care. I didn't have nothing to live for besides the weekend, right? And I got pregnant, and that changed everything for me because I looked at the way I was raised. I didn't know how to be a mom because my mom wasn't present. She didn't know how to love me. She was in foster care. You know what I'm saying? She did her best to provide, but she didn't know what I needed from a financial literacy standpoint. And I was in a situation at my job where I shifted from that to the mill, and I was making $21 an hour, full benefits. Baby was 6 months old, and I found out that they were going to fire me for telling on my foreman for sexually harassing me. And I don't know if any of you guys have dealt with the same type of situation, but every night at work, it was a nightmare, hoping that I wouldn't have to see him. I would work extra hard. I tried to stare on as many other people as I could because I was terrified to lose my job. I was a single mom, just got out of an abusive relationship. I want you guys to understand at this point, I was 300 pounds. I was dealing with severe depression. I was breastfeeding. And I was like, my breast milk was starting to dry up. I felt like a horrible mom because I was working longer than I was spending time with my baby. He didn't learn his ABCs from me. And that was the day that I drew the line. And I had someone who was driving around in a fancy car in my community, and no one else was. And I was like, hey, bro, what do you do? And he introduced me to network marketing. That changed my life. I did not, and I people don't like to talk about network marketing. I fucking talk about it because it's my first step. And I think that everyone should try it once because the communication skills, the personal development, the ability to sell anything. I mean, back when I started, it was the 3-foot rule. You guys get social media and funnels. I had to tell everyone in the grocery store about the product I was taking, and I believed in it. So everyone bought it because I was like, this changed my life. But 2 weeks into my business, I got my first $1,600 paycheck. I walk into the office after being suspended for 3 days, and my head of hiring says, you're either going to have to move to relief shift or you're fired. I didn't fucking deserve that. And for the first day in my life, I stood up for myself, and I looked at him, and I thought about that money that just hit my account. And I was like, you know what? I'm good. And fuck you kindly. And I walked out, and that walk from the top of the mill down to the parking lot, which is about a quarter mile. It's probably more than that. It was why I was strutting, you guys, because the one thing that I knew is that from the streets to that mill and now into my business, I always had my own back. I want you guys to understand that. Just have your own back in this situation. You know, Shylo, we were talking, I'm gonna air your laundry for a second and in a very nice way. But yeah, we were talking about, you know, her social media, because she's a goat. Like, literally, when it comes to networking, there's no one that beats out Shylo. But we were talking about social media, and she's like, I just don't want, you know, I don't want to learn everything again because we're tired. We've been working our butts off for a long time. And I was like, but you're already putting effort here. Wouldn't you like to have more efficient tools in your tool belt? And she goes, yeah, I would. And as vulnerable as someone who's me personally, I know a lot of shit, you guys. So I don't like to be admitting that I don't know stuff. Mm-hmm. And people, I'm going to say this really quick and then I'll pass it back to you so we can close out. But a lot of us feel bad that we're jack of all trades. And I want to tell you something. This is the saying that changed my life. I learned it on Clubhouse at the beginning of the year. It changed my life. They say a jack of all trades is a master of none. That's all I've ever heard my whole life, right? But guess what the whole saying is? A jack of all trades is a master of none, but oftentimes better than a master of one. This saying completely changed my life. And you want to know why? Because jack of all trades, they're your CEOs. They're your presidents of your company. Those are your entrepreneurs who are able to see like I see, where I can see all the systems in my business and know how to, because I'm a jack of all trades, I know how hard it is to do marketing and PR and media. And I know how hard it is for me to go facilitate customer relations, sales, and all those things. So when I find someone who's an expert in that place, I recognize them because I am a jack of all trades, and I am able to facilitate leverage way further than someone who's just a master of one. What did that guy say? I don't remember who it is, but I said this on the last episode, I'm gonna say it again. He said, I'd rather have the efforts of 100 people, 1% of 100 people's efforts than 100% of my own. And I want you to understand that if you've been struggling being a jack of all trades and you're looking at wanting to go into a place of leveraging resources, information, time, experts, know that because you've tried it all, you have tools in your tool belt to recognize what it means to have value, to recognize someone who can take you to the next level. The next step as a woman, and I want you to talk on this before we close, Shylo, is trusting yourself to make those investments, because so many times we're afraid of overhead. We're afraid of those commitments, but you are someone that does it big. You are someone that steps in. I mean, y'all, she freaks me out. We had this conversation earlier. She freaks me out because she's like, we're going. And I'm like, heck yeah, because I told her, I was like, those are big shoes to fill and I'm going to continue to step in them. And I want you to share a little bit about what that looks like as a jack of all trades, someone who's done it all and someone who continues to do it all. Now you're relieving that burden of yourself by delegating and leveraging. Mm. And how do you get past that state of fear and making those big decisions?
You have to stop being afraid to be accountable. This is something we don't talk about enough. And this is something I think is strength. So there are people who, I was in a chat and someone's like, I'll never admit defeat. It was a joke. So I'm not putting this person down, but I thought about it. And I'm like, no, you should. And you need to humble. This isn't towards that, but I started thinking about that process, who people who actually think like that. I was like, this was a joke. And obviously we're all bantering back and forth, like, we'll never give up. And it's like, I get it. But I used to be that way. And I said something on a post the other day, and I'm like, is your need to be right destroying you? Because listen, when you talk about the jack of all trades, it's so interesting. I will do a lot of things. And I might do it really messy, but I'm like, at least if I freaking do it, I'm going to learn something from it. Like, I don't know what I'm doing in some of the things we're doing right now. I don't know a lot. Me having the ability to say, I don't know what this is the biggest strength for me, because it opens the door for somebody to come in. And even if this is how you believe, and this is how Meaghan believes, and I believe the universe, God, whoever's got you, they're going to facilitate you.
Mm-hmm.
When you open that door, but the problem is when you're closed and you don't admit defeat, when you don't, and now there's a mental thing where people say, well, don't admit defeat. It doesn't mean that you're giving up. It means I am not doing this well and I feel defeated, but it's going to open the door for me to walk through and conquer it now. Now I'm going to master it because I hit the ground, right? I fell on my face. That's okay. And I think we talk about don't be afraid to fail. But when you are accountable and you say, okay, I'm going to do all these things, and I went all in. Like when I say I went all in, you know the play I'm playing. It's like, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it scared. I'm going to do it because I have opened my life up to trust the right people. That's the other thing. I know that the people I'm aligned with will never let me fall. Even if I get close, they're going to say, no, we're going to help you. We're going to get you through this. You're going to have to. And here's the part. You're going to have to be willing to learn some things. Mm-hmm. And when you're closed off and when you think you're right all the time, imagine all those moments you could have learned and became an expert here and an expert here and a jack of all trades. That's how you, and she's right about that. Like when you look at some of the biggest, most successful people, their stories are not much different than yours. Elon Musk, let's use him. We can use Elon Musk. We can use a bunch of these people. Elon Musk, you either love him or hate him. He's very eccentric. But he's failed several times. He didn't come into this and go, everything was perfect. I know everything. No, he made tons of mistakes. He does it publicly. You want to know why I respect an entrepreneur and MLMers big time? Why I respect someone who's an MLM, anybody who puts himself out publicly to the world and says, I'm starting something new and I've never done it. I have no network and they did it. That's respect, because they're willing to do what 90% of the other people aren't doing. And everyone's going, can't wait to see how that goes. And they put them down, they put them down. But it's so fun when they go, I got a car. I got my family out of debt. I'm not hyping up MLM, but hey, it's the platform that got me where I am. Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't I praise it? You know, I've seen the good, the bad, the ugly of that industry. And I will tell you that even though I've seen the really, really bad side of it, I've reaped the benefits of the good side. And it's great. And that's the point. And so as we close, we want to encourage you, hit up Meaghan, hit up her courses. If this is something you're like, you feel that in your stomach, because I know I get that way when I'm like, I don't understand this and now I'm really scared. Don't be scared. We've got it. And if we don't have it, we humble ourselves enough to know to say, I know who does. I'm going to guide you to that person. And that's a true entrepreneur, the one who connects. Being a connector is the name of the game.
Yeah.
Well, let's play the game. So this is another incredible episode of The Classroom. I'm Shylo Bijou. That's Meaghan Monroe. You know where we're at. I'll catch you on the next one.
Glutathione is a big word. It's the body's own master antioxidant. It's a scavenger for free radical, bacteria, and viruses. There are no products in the market with the ingredient NASET. NASET increases the production of glutathione that's in our body already to strengthen and enhance our immune system, elevate sense of well-being, support muscle strength and endurance, cognitive function, and liver support. It helps with increased energy and blood sugar regulation. Get your bottle of GSH Plus from www.salvationnutra.com.